Good morning, St. Paul.
Good morning, friend.
Now, Joyce back from her treatment. How are you doing, Joyce? Good, good. Meet your family first time in New Year. Happy New Year. How are you doing? We welcome our visitor again. Ernie, glad you're back. And how are you, everybody? Welcome all who are coming into in-person worship. And also all who are worship with us on online around. And Bob, you come back to worship after Bob's medical treatment. All right, good. Let's see you all. Today is our special day, second Sunday of January, New Year, and the second Sunday of our series sermon on. And then also today we remember on a baptism. This is the day we remember Jesus' baptism also. The Sunday, the baptism of Jesus, baptism of the Lord. So we have some our reaffirmation of baptism today. Before that, I'll invite Tom to give us the announcements.
Thank you. Good morning to everyone. We ought to try that again. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Thank you. So good. It's a bright, sunny day, and the earth is so beautiful with the light white covering that stayed just on the grass just perfectly. Isn't that a miracle? I tell you, that was so nice. So it's a beautiful day. It's God's day. We're together, either here in person or online, and we are so happy to be doing so because we know that we are a congregation that is growing into a most vibrant, joyful Christian community, unified in loving service to our neighbors for the glory of God. Let us be about God's work in our daily lives. We do have some birthdays to observe here early in the year. We have Jim Maddox has a birthday on the 10th, Jose Lugo on the 15th, and David Linkus also on the 15th. And we encourage you to give birthday greetings to those persons as you have the opportunity and to remember them and celebrate their life and their walk in Christ and with us. We do have persons for whom we have concerns. We want to keep these persons particularly in mind before us and in your prayers as you have your daily prayers, in addition to those persons that you remember in your hearts and know individually, but let us also remember these. William Ronnie Hawkins, friends and family of Catherine Lawrence, friends and family of Bessie Turner, who is Brenda Linkus's mother, Brenda and David Linkus and family, the family and friends of Jane Stafford, the Moy family, family of Jane Stafford, family and friends of Kelly Walters, Woody and Kathy Nestor, Larry and Clara Sowers, Ernie Akers, Janet Slesher, Dolores and Wayne Brockenborough, Jimmy Williams, Dennis and Betty Simonis, Sue Croy, Jimmy Reynolds, Betty Linkus, and Ronnie Blancett, a new friend and visitor with us last week and today, who's up front here for those of you who do not know. So let us keep these persons in prayer for the challenges, physical and otherwise, that they are experiencing at this time. I do want to remind everyone that, as mentioned last week, that there will be a church council meeting on the 18th via Zoom. That's 8 days away. I want to remind you as well that we have a new yearly Bible reading program. This year, we're going to focus on history, reading the 12 books of the Old Testament, Joshua to Esther. That is available on the website, printed copies in the narthex for those who are here or will stop by later in the week. There is also going to be a finance committee meeting this coming Thursday evening at 7 p.m. via Zoom. Unless there are any other announcements from the congregation that's here, that would be all for this morning, Pastor.
Thank you, Tom. All believers by baptism are initiated to the kingdom of God, to the membership of the local church. So today, a special day as you remember the baptism of the Lord Jesus Christ by the Jordan, and also remember our own baptism. And if you're already baptized, let us join to this reaffirmation of your baptism. However, if you have not baptized yet, please consider you to be baptized and let us know how do you baptize. So let us together, brothers and sisters. Through the sacraments of baptism, we are initiated into Christ's holy church. We are incorporated into God's mighty acts of salvation and given new birth through water and the Spirit. All this is God's gift, offered to us without price. Through the reaffirmation of our faith, we renew the covenant declared at our baptism, acknowledge what God is doing for us, and affirm our commitment to Christ's holy church. On behalf of the whole church, I ask you, all those who are baptized, and then also who are considered to be baptized, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness and reject the evil powers of this world and repent of your sin? Do you accept the freedom, the power that God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves?
I do.
Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior, put your whole trust in His grace, and promise to serve Him as your Lord, in union with the church which Christ has opened to people of all ages, nations, and races?
I do.
According to the grace given to you, will you remain faithful members of Christ's holy church? In general and in specific, St. Paul United Methodist Church, the church you love, church you serve, church you participate in ministry, and serve as Christ's representative in the world.
I will.
So therefore, let us join together in professing the Christian faith as contained in the scriptures of the Old and New Testament. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ? I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. Born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and then buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day, He rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father. And He will come again to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
The water that you baptized with long years ago, and the water that we want to use as your reminder of your baptism. Let us pray. Eternal Father, when nothing exists but chaos, you swept across the dark waters and brought forth light. In the days of Noah, you saved those on the ark through water. After the flood, you set in the clouds a rainbow when you saw your people as slaves in Egypt. You led them to freedom through the sea. Their children you brought through the Jordan River
to the land which you promised. In the fullness of time, you sent Jesus nurtured in the water womb. He was baptized by John and anointed by your Spirit. He called his disciples to share in the baptism of his death and resurrection and to make disciples of all nations. Lord, pour out your Holy Spirit by this gift of water, water called to our remembrance, reaffirmation, the grace declared to us in our baptism, and also to those who will be considered to be baptized. For you have washed away our sins. You clothe us with righteousness throughout our lives, that dying and rising with Christ, we may share in his final victory. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Remember your baptism and be thankful. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, let us rejoice in the faithfulness of our covenant through baptism together. We give thanks for all that God has already given us as members of the body of Christ. And in this congregation of the United Methodist Church, we will faithfully participate in the ministries of the church by our prayers, our presence, our gifts, and our service, that in everything God may be glorified through Jesus Christ. God of us all grace, who has called us to eternal glory in Christ, establish and strengthen you by the power of the Holy Spirit, that we may live in grace and peace always. Amen.
Let us rise here as you are able and at home as you will to join together in the call to worship. Ascribe to the Lord, O heavenly beings. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory of God's name. Worship the Lord in holy array. The voice of the Lord is upon the water. The God of glory thunders, the Lord upon many waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. Let us praise the name of the Lord. Let us remain standing and join together in singing the Spirit song. Please be seated. Let us join together in this morning's opening prayer. Most wonderful God, foolish and flawed though we are, we too delight in your beloved Son. As in his name we gather in the house of many praises, may the heavens be opened for us, that we may catch a glimpse of that light and love that transforms our common days with a beauty not of our making. Through Jesus Christ our Lord we pray. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you. Let us prepare our minds and hearts to hear the reading of God's word and pray together this prayer for illumination. Lord, open our hearts and minds by the power of your Holy Spirit, that as the scriptures are read and your word proclaimed, we may hear with joy what you say to us today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Turning to the Old Testament, the book of Jeremiah, we read these several verses. The word of the Lord came to Jeremiah a second time, while he was still confined in the court of the guard. Thus says the Lord who made the earth, the Lord who formed it to establish it, the Lord is his name. Call to me, and I will answer you, and will tell you great and hidden things that you have not known. Let us turn then to the New Testament, Paul's first letter to the Thessalonians, where we hear these several verses from Paul. Rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen. Now we will hear the praise hymn, Baptized in Water, by the faith we sing. I believe we're going to join together in this, as you're able.
By the Spirit, cleansed by the blood, Christ now I see. Heirs of salvation, trust in God. Praise to him now, good, God's grace we sing. Baptized in
Let us turn now to the Gospel of Matthew. where we read these words concerning prayer. And whenever you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners, so that they may be seen by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But whenever you go to pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. When you are praying, do not heap up empty phrases as the Gentiles do, for they think that they will be heard because of their many words. Do not be like them, for your Father knows what you need before you ask him. Pray then in this way: Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And do not bring us to the time of trial, but rescue us from the evil one. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus, teach us how to pray as you taught your disciples. Whenever we come and pray to you out of your love and grace, O Lord, hear and answer our prayer so that we will always live in your presence, your power, promise. Lord, we humbly beseech you in this time of worship. So speak to us, O Lord, into our hearts, our minds. Speak to us, O Lord. In your name we prayed. Amen. We read the Bible and learn that God asked the question when God has in mind something new to bring forth, such as in the Genesis. God asked Adam and Eve, "Adam, where are you?" When they hide themselves from the presence of God after they sin against God. And God asked Elijah, Prophet Elijah, "Elijah, what are you doing here?" When Elijah fled himself from the angry, killing hands of Queen Jezebel, even after he did a wonderful, successful ministry in his life. And then risen Lord Jesus asked Peter, "Peter, son of John, do you love me more than this?" Three times, same question. Do you love me more than this? Three times. At Galilean Tiberias Sea, after Jesus rose from the dead. Now, as we begin a new year, I feel inspired in my imagination to pose a question that God would ask us today. Today, beloved, what do you want to begin with in this new year that I granted you to live? What do you want to begin with? It is my inspirational question in my imagination from God. What do we begin with? And I build up the sermon series for January based upon this question. so that we may listen to God's voice into our hearts and mind. Last Sunday, answer was with the Word of God, scripture reading, meditation, daily base. Today, it is praying. Our answer is praying. What do we begin with? It's praying. Begin all things by praying, whatever we do, every day throughout the year. Not only for individual base, for your family, yourself, but as a church, I mean, all the leaders of the church, let us remind it of ourselves that we are called to pray first before we set up any plan. We want to bring it out to God first, asking, God, what is your will? What are you calling us to do before we set out our own plan? That's what we envision this year. Come to God first in prayer. Prayer, praying is the first thing we do before we begin anything in life. So let prayer to God, praying to God, be the first thing we do, you do, in your family, in your business, in your work, and then communally as well, as a church, St. Paul United Methodist Mission and Ministry, before we do anything this year, this morning. And then I invite you to meditate on prayer with three reflecting questions about the prayer. First question is, why do we pray? Why do we pray? And then how do we pray? Third is, what do we pray? Let us reflect on. Why do you pray? Why do we pray? Why? Praying is a spiritual breath for our faith journey, spiritual life. Now, as the human body can survive with breathing, and when it stops breathing, our body dies. We know that. So does our spiritual life die when we stop praying. Shall we practice it? Shall we? Would you please hold your breath? Hold your breath. Hold your breath and see how long can we go? How long can you go? Oh, breathing, please. Now. Do we feel it? Yes. Same way for our spiritual life as well. Breath is necessary for our human body, our life. And prayer is spiritual breath necessary for our faith life. There is a very basic. Why do we pray? Jesus himself prayed. Jesus himself, Son of God, himself prayed. And then how much we need more, right? Jesus spent 40 days in the wilderness in his own prayer, solitude with God, silent prayer with God, before he began his public ministry. 40 days in the wilderness. And then Jesus prayed to God all night long before he chose 12 people to follow him, to work for the kingdom of God. All night long before he selected the 12 people. Leadership. That's what leadership lesson we learn.
Jesus prayed before he raised Lazarus from his death. And Jesus prayed at Gethsemane to discern God's will for strength to bear the cross coming into him. Why do we pray? God is always ready to meet with us in prayer, in his presence. Jeremiah, out of his nation's trouble, crisis coming on, God spoke to him, Jeremiah. That's what we read in the Old Testament passage. Call to me, and I will answer you and tell you great unsearchable things you do not know. That means God is always ready to hear from us. Ready. God is ready to. God wants us to. Another Jeremiah 29. And God says, you will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart. I will be found by you. God said, I will be found by you. It means God is always ready to meet with us. God wants us to pray. Teaching on prayer is one of Jesus' teachings on his Sermon on the Mount, Matthew, the Gospel, 5 to 7, three chapters. We read a part of it today. Jesus said, when you pray, go to your room, go into your room, close the doors, and pray to your Father. Go to your room is very symbolic teaching, meaning deep meaning with it. That means God wants to meet with you personally. With no distractions, no worries. But God directly, personally want to meet with you. So go to your room. Pray. God wants us to have a commune with us, communication with us, communion with us by speaking to God in prayer and then listening to communication between God and us. One-on-one base relationship that God is seeking with us in the room. In his teaching on the Trinitarian way of Christian living, Apostle Paul, as we read it in Epistles, 1 Thessalonians, Apostle Paul teaches this. Be joyful, first, always. Pray continually, second. And then give thanks in all circumstances. That is our Trinitarian way of Christian living. In this passage, we hear what God wants to speak to us, that praying is God's will for us. God wants us to pray. Second reflection question is, and then how do we pray? How? Some Christians answer that, oh, I don't know how to pray good prayer. So whenever I was asked to pray by someone, I feel awkward or uneasiness, uncomfortable, and I'm afraid. Of course, there must be some very basic knowledge on prayer, how to pray. A couple of years, 2 weeks, 2 years ago, our church offered the small group studying on prayer. It is called the Way of Prayer. The Way of Prayer. In that class, we read Thomas Merton, the Catholic spiritual leaders years ago, well known.
Thomas Merton wrote this phrase, "If you want a life of prayer, the way to get it is praying, is by praying. You start where you are and you deepen what you already have." That means the best way to know about prayer is praying itself rather than learning from some theological definition, biblical definition, or other techniques. No. Praying itself is the best way to learn about praying. Prayer. So through that class, we read a variety of ways that we can learn more about the way of prayer and what the way of prayer is really fitted to me according to my own personality style, such as praying by heart silence and praying with music, praying by gazing, praying with our body prayer, pray by breathing prayer, and scripture prayer, praying the Psalms and contemplative prayers, and on many ways, so that we might find, oh, this is the way I think most fitted to me in prayer, and then also grow more by trying other forms of prayer. That's what we did 2 years ago. Praying is just bursting our hearts, pressing our hearts with yearning and eagerness to God in all the ways, in all circumstances. There are many ways of praying, many forms of praying, and Jesus taught in our gospel reading today. Go to your room, bring out your hearts to God, commune with God, solicit your God with your sincere heart, honest mind, and have a commune with God. A very senior man was dying at the hospital. Very next to his dying bed, there is an empty chair. He was a Catholic Christian. The reason was this. His priest in the Catholic Church taught them about praying. Out of that lesson, he found out that, oh, I know when I pray, God is with me. God is watching over me. God is listening to me. So in his own imagination, he made an empty chair for Christ, Jesus Christ, beside him, always. So whenever he prayed by the chair. So he prayed, Lord Jesus, kind of. That was his way of prayer. So he was caught by cancer, serious cancer, and he was dying. And when he was brought to the hospital, he asked to bring his prayer chair with him. Stay there with him by his dying, his bed, hospital bed. Even to the point when he was dying, his praying chair beside his dying bed. He died in peacefully. Watching over the chair means Jesus Christ was watching over me in this time of my dying in peace. It is his prayer. His prayer. Another Protestant Christians. It is another man. Let us call him John. John stopped by the church every day. Every day. In curiosity, and the church secretary asked him, John, why do you come to church every day? And he said, oh, to pray to God. And the secretary found out that John was just stayed very short period of time. Short time, I mean, less than 5 minutes or one day, 1 minute, 2 minutes, he left. He came in, left. staying short. Curiosity, secretary asked him, John, you pray when you stay very short. How to pray? And John said, I come to the sanctuary and stand before the altar. I pray that, Lord, I am here. Lord, I am here. And he left. When he visited his friend in the hospital room, his friend said, John, when you come to me, I feel the Lord is with you. The Lord of Jesus Christ coming with you. John's habit of coming to the church in prayer every day be a means of carrying the presence of God with him wherever he goes. So people feel it. Presence of God with him. It is John's way of prayer. Presence of God. Carrying the presence of God. Reverend John Piper, very nationally known preacher and also a spiritual leader, writing the many spiritual books. He defined prayer, very simple definition of prayer. He said, prayer is this, saying this, Lord, Lord, you are good. Lord, I need you. And thank you, Lord. That's it. Lord, you are good. I need you. Thank you. And he said, apply all your situation by this three phrase. Lord, you're good, but I'm not. Lord, I need you. Even though I'm facing the many difficulties, I need you. In assurance of God's answering to his prayer, finally, thank you, Lord. Thank you. Now, prayer is the heart. Praying the good prayer is the heart. Go from your heart first. First in your heart, whatever way, whatever you say to God. And God is always ready to listen to your prayer. The loving God. God says that. Call to me. I will answer you. Tell you. Unsearchable things. Great and unsearchable things you do not know. So Apostle Paul, in his teaching prayer to Ephesians church, he said that pray in Ephesians chapter 6. Pray in the Spirit in all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. All kinds of prayers. In all occasions. You can pray anywhere. You can pray all kinds of prayers. As we pray consistently, persistently, we will find our own form, our own style. Prayer. Last question is, what do we pray? What do we pray? Jesus teaches us what to pray in the Lord's Prayer in our gospel reading. Glorifying God. Seek the will of God. Seeking the forgiveness and give thanks. Asking supplications. And some said there are four acronyms of Lord's Prayers praying on this. X, A-C-T-S, in the Lord's Prayer. A means acclamation of God, our Father who is in heaven. And C means confessing the sins. Forgive our trespasses. T means thanksgiving. S means supplication. So there's four contents of prayer acts in Lord's Prayer. Second, you can build up on it according to your own need, according to your situation, what you have in mind is your hearts in all circumstances, situations. But we pray to know God better. Praying to God is not just for our own sake, no. Praying is to know God better, God's will, God's presence. And Apostle Paul set an example in his prayer for the Ephesian church as well. So Ephesians chapter 1, he taught about it. Three things. Pray that you may know God better. Pray that you may know the hope to which God has called you, hope. And then pray so that you may know God's uncomparable great power. Ephesians chapter 1. That's what Apostle Paul taught about prayer to his church in Ephesians. Pray to know God better. Pray to know God's hope that we are called. One hope we are called to. And then pray to know God's power. You know, when you read the Bible, there are a lot of prayers and then all the experiencing the power of God in the Bible. Such as when Moses prayed, what happened? Red Sea was divided. Right? And then when Prophet Isaiah prayed in crisis of his nation's crisis, attacking by Assyrian army. Prophet Isaiah prayed and saw the army angel of the Lord is coming here to protect them. He saw it. When Hannah, child's mother, bursting her own heart to God in prayer, when Hannah prayed it, God gave him a son named Samuel. When Prophet Elijah prayed 3 years of drought that destroyed all his nations, stopped and then rain started coming. When he prayed, when Elijah prayed, he divided the Jordan River. When Daniel prayed in Babylonia in captivity, Daniel prayed 3 times a day, every day. When he was put in lion's den, what happened? God kept the mouth of lions from harming him. When Apostle Paul put it in jail in Philippi jail prison, he prayed to God in praising God, and then jail doors open. When Apostle Peter was put in prison again because he preached the resurrection of Jesus Christ, and whole church prayed for him, what happened? Earthquake happened, and all the prison doors opened, and Peter set free from. We read George Mueller in England, the father of orphans. George Mueller was able to feed 1,700 orphans every day. Prayer. A prayer. Dear friends, this new year hope to be our opportunity to know God by our experience through prayer. I hope this year is the year that we learn, we begin to pray before we begin anything. Pray first. Reverend Bill Hybel in the big church in Illinois wrote the book about prayer. Title is Too Busy to Pray. And then he challenges all Christians in his book asking this question: are we too busy to pray? Are we too busy to pray? Very challenging. I hope and pray that St. Paul United Methodist Church and an all congregation may know the power of prayer this year as we practice actual praying for all occasions, all praying. Pray first. Bring it to God first before we plan. In closing meditation, I want to read with you Philippians passage, chapter 4. Let us memorize this passage and put it into our daily lives. Shall we read together? Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. May God bless you all. May God bless the life of St. Paul Church. Let us pray. Lord, teach us how to pray every day, and help us to live daily lives in your presence, in your power, by your promise. Help us growing in our spiritual life through praying, O Lord. Now we lift up our hearts and mind and pray. Merciful God, hear our prayers. We pray for all the congregation of your body, St. Paul Church, this year. In this time of pandemic, still there are suffering, sicknesses, fear, anxiety, uncertainty, feeling of aloneness, loneliness. Lord, have mercy on us. Send us your words that we can live by every day. Help us to pray daily base that we may know you each day. Your love and grace, your healing, your communion with us. So that all our lives live alive and vital in our relationship with you, O Lord. As Isaiah saw the vision of your angel army in their crisis, help us to see your vision amidst of this pandemic time, O Lord. Merciful God, hear our prayers. Now we lift up our nation to you. As you have seen the division, strife, and fighting, violations, and deaths happened still, especially last week. Oh Lord, violence on Capitol Hill area, Capitol building. Lord, forgive our sin. And forgive our unfaithfulness. Lord, have mercy on us. Deliver our nation from this division. Heal our nation from this hatredness, violence,
Especially we pray for the leaders of our nation, living president and newly elected president and the new government, his cabinet, Lord. Lead them to lead our nation, the people, by your love, by your mercy, by your justice, so that we can see again in our nation glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Renew our calling to be the nation, beloved, nation to be the means of your love and grace toward the world, as our nation was established by faith long, long years ago. Renew our faith, O Lord. Merciful God, hear our prayers. We pray for all those who are in sicknesses, illnesses, those who are suffered from coronavirus, and we pray for all the administrators who are diligently working for the safety of our nation's healthcare department, healthcare workers, law enforcement, government staffs, all, especially by your grace, new vaccines starting administering to our nation. Oh Lord, keep all the process, transportation, the way of giving the vaccine, be under your loving grace. Heavenly Father, merciful God, hear our prayers. We pray for St. Paul United Methodist, your church, and pray for the United Methodist denomination, and we pray for all the churches, all denominations. Help us to be the light of the world, the salt of the Lord, in this time of confrontations, in this time of suffering, in this time of uncertainty, O Lord. Help us to be the light of the world, reflecting the light of Jesus Christ. Merciful God, hear our prayer. And now we pray for our individual prayer in silence. Lord, continue to hear and then answer our prayers. Merciful God, hear our prayers. And now we pray together the Lord's Prayer that he taught us to do. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those trespasses against us. That lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and glory forever. Amen.
As we come to a time of considering our gifts, it is well that we've been reminded of our discipleship. We have reaffirmed our baptism. We have renewed our commitments. So let us remember that we must love, we must give, we must serve, as we are led, and through prayer, we can discern that leading. We are able to give online, through the mail, in person. There are many ministries to be supported, many needs to be addressed. God gives us the opportunity. God is working. Let us work with him. Let us give joyfully. Let us prepare our commitments. Let us prepare our commitments anew for this year. For we will be having a formal time of commitment in the coming weeks, and we want to be prepared for that. Amen.
God Almighty, we give our thanks. We are thankful and grateful for your love and grace, your presence and power, promise. You called us to be the means of your kingdom, so therefore we offer ourselves to you. And we offer this visible sign of gratitude, thanksgiving, through mailing, dropping, and online. Lord, use us and use them, for your kingdom come. Bless us and bless them, O Lord, always for your glory. In Jesus' name we prayed. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious always. May the Lord turn his face toward you always and give you peace. Therefore, go now in peace and love and joy, to serve the Lord, to serve each other, to love the Lord, love each other. As you go, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion and fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forever and evermore. Amen.